So I'm Duc Thinh Pham, cardiac surgeon at Northwestern Medicine and associate professor of surgery at Weinberg School of Medicine.
I'm Shohei Yoshida. I'm an advanced cardiac surgery fellow, specialized heart transplant and also mechanical circulatory support.
Extracorporeal membrane oxygenation is a therapy for patients with cardiogenic shock. It does a great job of stabilizing patients and perfusing the rest of the body while the heart recovers from whatever injury it suffered. The problem with it is that it increases the afterload or the work that the heart has to do and therefore can be detrimental in its the heart recovery. Our study was to look at different ways to relieve the work on the heart, in other words, venting the heart. And there are a couple modalities which we could do it, and we're looking to see which one is the most optimal for our patients.
Each LV venting strategy has an advantage and then disadvantage. So we use a couple of methods. Direct LV vent is the most robust effect, but the device we cannot use for the patient, for example, LV thrombus, aortic insufficiency, those patients we cannot use. And then the other way, we have another device that is PA vent or a balloon pump. Then those has also disadvantage. So we are thinking which method is the best for the patient.
One more novel way that we started using for a while at Northwestern was a indirect venting method where we put a catheter into the pulmonary artery and we drain the pulmonary artery and therefore indirectly unloading the left atrium and the left ventricle. It's debatable and when we ran the study as to how effectively it does unload the LV vent. In our study, looking at hemodynamics, we've seen that actually it does a very good job of unloading the left ventricle. The other advantage of it is, with that strategy is that later on as the patient recovers and they don't need left ventricular support anymore, we can take the left ventricular support out, but may still be able to use that cannula to oxygenate the blood while the lung recovers from the injuries. The impact I think our study will show is that we need to give the heart some time to recover. The earlier you vent the LV, the better the prognosis is. Which venting strategy is something I think needs to be studied further. And I think our institutional study here will lead to multi-center studies that will look into this a little bit further. And I hope in the end that it will inform an algorithm for different strategies for different patients.